guys, welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for coming back. For those of you who are new to my channel, my name is Mercy. I am a BSN RN, and on this channel I talk about nursing, lifestyle, beauty. I do a little bit of vlogging. I just do a little bit of everything. So if you would like to join my family, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button down below, and also hit the bell notification button right next to the subscribe button so that you will never miss another video from me again. So if you want to know everything I regret about being a nurse, then please stay tuned for the video. Before we get into the video, I want to tell you guys about my hair, because I know you guys are gonna ask. As I told you guys in some of my previous videos, I started my own hairline. This is a bob. It's a custom unit made by me. I will leave the name somewhere here, or I will leave it down in the description below. So the bundles of hair is from my hair company, Nimba Beauty Hair. We sell all kinds of bundles, straight, curly, kinky curl, whatever curl you want. And I also make custom wigs. So this wig was made by me. And also the necklace I'm wearing, you probably can't see it because of my dress and the ruffles up here, but it is an African pendant map necklace. We have different kinds of very unique pieces on the website. I will also leave the name here and in the description below, so please check those out. Thank you so much again for your love and support. So let's get right into the video. So recently, as a lot of you know, I've been going through a transition because I recently had a baby and I gave up my position at the hospital, but I've been doing home care here and there for the past month or so. So one of my viewers sent me an email telling me about her regrets about nursing, and she wanted to know if I can give any advice that would either make her feel better or make her decide to go back into nursing. So this particular person is a 25-year-old female new nurse who recently got a job in MedSurg. She has been working in MedSurg for about 4 months and she completely hates it, and she feels like she doesn't know what she's doing. She don't feel like she fits in with the rest of everybody else because everybody else seems to know more than she does, and she just doesn't think that nursing is for her. So when I saw that email, I thought it was very touching because I myself have been through that before. Let me just say first off that being a new nurse, I thought being a nursing student was hard, but being a new nurse is another level of hard. It's stressful, it's scary, it's just on a whole different level by itself. So for me, being a new nurse, I've shared my experience with you guys before. I was unfortunate to get a job on a unit that was very, very, very unfriendly. My preceptor was very unfriendly to me. She treated me like I didn't belong there. She would tell me things to hurt me. She would just make me feel like an outcast or something like that. And unfortunately for me, this particular nurse had worked on that unit for a while, so she had a lot of friends, so she had a bigger alliance than I did. I really didn't have any alliance because I didn't know anybody there. So when she would treat me horribly, I didn't have anybody to talk to because everybody was her friend, and I was a new girl, not knowing anything and not knowing who to talk to. So unfortunately for me, I ended up leaving that job. And when I left that job, I for some reason felt like this is how the entire nursing field is. I thought everybody was mean and nasty and just not supportive. So I thought to myself, I don't want to go through this for the rest of my career. I'm young, I can go back to school and get another degree, or I can just do something else with my life. But this is too stressful, because I was heading into a really, really dark place. I felt myself slowly going into a deep depression because I was unhappy. I didn't want to hang out with anybody. I wasn't answering my family members' phone calls. I wasn't hanging out with my friends. I would just literally go to work my entire 12-hour shift, sit in my car, cry for like ever, and then drive home and then continue my crying, take a shower, barely eat, go to sleep, and repeat the next day. As I said, I was heading down a really, really bad path. So I finally came to the decision of quitting my job. And when I quit my job, I told myself that I was done with nursing. I was not gonna go back. I was not gonna get treated like that anymore. I just was gonna waste all the years I had gone to school. I didn't care at that moment. I was just done. The thing about it is, I didn't really know that I could, number one, talk to my manager or supervisor. I didn't know that I could go to HR. I was younger and I was naive, so I just thought it was me against the world. So that is the reason I left that job. So the reason I'm telling you guys this story is, not only did I have to deal with that nurse, I also had to deal with the fact that I was a new nurse, I didn't know anything. I felt inadequate. I felt like I didn't learn enough from nursing school. And I just never thought that I would get to a point where I could be fully trusted with a patient, or even more than one patient at a time. So I had all of that going through my head. And as a new nurse, this is something that is very, very, very serious, and it's very, very important to talk about. A lot of jobs offer something called a nurse residency program. This is different for every program or every hospital, but for my hospital, this was kind of like a support group where all the new nurses and all the new hires would go and meet up and talk about, you know, their progress, their feelings, their fears, their you know, what intimidates them, and also learn some new skills before actually performing those skills on actual patients. So that is what my program was about, and I thought it was very, very helpful. As a new nurse, when you're looking for a job at a hospital, I would highly suggest that you look for jobs that has nurse residency programs, because those programs are very, very helpful. Because not only do you have your preceptor, you also have the nurse residency program where you can go and talk to your peers, share your feelings, and learn new skills. So that was very important for me when I was looking for a job. The reason this topic is very important is, for my viewer who sent me that email, I don't want to say her name because I want it to be private, but I want to say that whatever you're feeling is 100% legit. Being a new nurse is the scariest thing ever, because when you're a nursing student, you have your professor there. You also have your classmates, and then you also have other nurses on the unit, wherever your clinical is. So you have kind of like a support system, and you feel comfortable asking questions because you're learning at this point. But when you become a new nurse, especially those early stages, transitioning from your preceptor to being on your own is the scariest thing ever. I've been through it before, and let me tell you, I've had days where, even when I left that toxic job, when I got a better job, when I finally became a nurse on my own, I was really, really scared. Like, I was not comfortable at all. Even the slightest, most simple skills scared me. I had to ask questions. I learned very early on that you had to make friends with the more experienced nurses, and you have to just know where your resources are, like the nurse educator, the charge nurse, the more experienced nurses, and your policy and procedures. Those things are very, very important. As a new nurse, you're gonna feel like you don't know anything, because clinical is different from real life. Nursing school is different from real life. Simulation is different from real life. So when you're finally on your own, you're gonna feel scared, you're gonna feel intimidated, you're gonna feel inadequate. My advice for you is, first of all, if you're still with a preceptor, I would say talk to your preceptor. If the person is a nice person, talk to them and tell them what your fears are. You never know, they might be willing to help you or to maybe explain things better than they have been doing. Because sometimes if you don't voice your opinion, people don't know. So your preceptor may be telling you something that they think you already know, so they might just, you know, touch on certain topics and not go into full details. But it's up to you to tell them, hey, I don't understand this, I need you to explain to me a little better. Or if there's a certain skill you're not comfortable performing, maybe talk to your nurse educator or your manager and ask them if you can go to something like a simulation lab where you can practice that skill until you perfect it so that you're more comfortable performing it on an actual patient. So that is one regret I have as well. Another regret I have is that, as I told you guys before, I didn't know that I could talk to my manager or my supervisor or go to HR because I was being bullied. I was being treated like I didn't belong there. I would literally go to the lunchroom to sit there and eat, and they would pack up their stuff and leave. I would ask questions and they would either ignore me or tell me I'm already supposed to know. So I just couldn't make friends with anybody. I couldn't talk to anybody because they made me feel very uncomfortable. Knowing what I know now, if I had gone and talked to my supervisor, maybe he would have paired me up with a different preceptor, or maybe changed my shift from day shift to night shift, or maybe escalated to someone that could actually help. Or if I had called HR and told them about this behavior, maybe something would have been done. But as I said, I was younger and I was naive, and I just didn't know what to do, so I ended up quitting. So before you quit your job, if this is a job you really, really like, I would say go talk to your manager. talk to your charge nurse and talk to someone that can really, you know, help guide you through, because this actually causes depression. I've heard stories where people have hurt themselves because of this. So just please go and talk to somebody. Also talk to your family members. Don't try to keep this to yourself, because there's nothing to be ashamed of at all. I was very ashamed when it happened to me because I felt like I was a failure. I felt like I was letting my family down and letting myself down by leaving my job. But I was so miserable, and I knew that I was heading somewhere that I didn't want to be. So I went ahead and made the decision I made. So I would say to you, please talk to your family members. Talk to someone you can trust. Talk to your charge nurse. Talk to your manager. Talk to HR if you're being bullied. Just talk to someone that can help you out of this, because it is not pretty and it's not fun. So I wish you all the best, my dear. I hope that answered your question. And if you have any other questions, and if any of my other viewers out there have any regrets or any advice, please leave it in the comments down below to share with the rest of us. It is very, very much appreciated. Thank you guys again so much for watching. If you liked the video, please go ahead and give it a big thumbs up. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and hit the subscribe button down below. I would highly appreciate it. And also, if you think the video was helpful to you, there is a good chance that it would be helpful to someone else. So please go ahead and share the video with all your friends and family. Don't forget to visit my website for the jewelry and the hair if you want to support my channel. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.